Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_002_BIAB_I. You can also download this file on the website. Go to the file tab and above the mouse cursor to save as, click project. This will bring the save project as dialog box. Rename this file to 00_003_BIAB_I and click the save button. Zoom out, right click the reference plan. Before we proceed, we need to correct something from the previous tutorial. Right click the reference plan and create similar. Draw a reference plan from this point to this point. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Now go to the quick access tool and select the align dimension command. Dimension from this reference plane to this reference plane and click to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Now select this dimension and change the value to 6 feet 9 3/4 and press enter. Press escape to deselect the reference plane. Select all the horizontal reference plane except the topmost and the bottommost and the middle reference plane. To deselect any reference plane that you don't want to select, hold down the shift key and click to deselect it. Now go to the modify tab and select the move command. Zoom in into this area. Click on the intersection of this line, the third horizontal left reference plane. Click and move it to the reference plan that you just dimensioned. Press escape to deselect reference plan. Select this reference plan and hit delete on your keyboard. The reference plan deletes with the dimension because the dimension don't have any object to reference plan. Now go to the architectural tab and select the wall command. Go to the property palette, click the down arrow and select the generic 6 inches wall. In the option bar, click this down arrow and select height and change to unconnected, select level 2. This way the wall will connect from level 1 to level 2. In the location line, click the down arrow and select the core center line. Go to the draw panel and select the pick line button. Zoom in and pick this reference plane. Pick this reference plane. Zoom out and move the mouse cursor at the top. Zoom in into this area. Pick this reference plane and pick this reference plane. Pick this reference plane. Pick this reference plane. Pick this reference plane. And pick this reference plane. This reference plane. Click the modify button. Now go to the modify tab, modify panel, and select the trim extend to corner button. Select this wall. This wall, this wall, this wall, this wall, this wall. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extent multiple elements. Select the edge of this wall. Click this wall, this wall, this wall. Press escape to get out of the command. Now right click the wall, create similar. Draw a wall from the center of this reference plane, the rest reference plane. Press escape twice to get out of the wall command. Now select this wall and see that the wall is 12 feet apart. But the Temporal dimension reference the world at the center of the world to the center of the world. We need to change this. To change this, go to the manage tab. Setting panel and click the additional setting. Move down your mouse cursor and select temporal dimension. The temporal dimension dialog box divided into two areas, the wall and the opening. Change the opening to face of core. Change the wall to face of core and the doors and window to opening. Click OK. Now select this wall. As you can see, this wall is 12 feet. Click the trim extend single element button. Select the edge of this wall and click to trim it. Press escape to get out of the corner. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Click the in the option bar, click the down arrow and select entire wall. Click the face of core and click the option button. Click, make sure that you check the intersecting wall and click OK. Select this wall and move the mouse cursor into this area and click to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Make sure that the dimension from this wall is 12 feet, this wall to this wall is 7 feet 6, this to this is 10 feet, and this to this is 8 feet 6. Right click the wall, grid similar, hover the mouse cursor into this area, you see a temporal dimension, make sure that, click to place the wall and move the mouse cursor down to complete the wall. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner command. Click this wall and this wall. Press escape. Now select this wall. Select this wall. Click this figure and change this to 10 feet. Press enter. Click on this grid and extend the wall to meet this wall. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner button. Select this wall and this wall. Press escape. Right click the wall and select grid similar. Start a wall from this point to this point. Press escape. Press escape again to get out of the wall corner. Select this wall and change this value to 4 feet. Press enter. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall. Press escape to get out of the corner. Right click the wall and select grid similar. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner command. Select this wall and this wall. Press escape. Now go to the slip, go to the modify panel and select the split element button. Click the delete inner segment. Hover the mouse cursor and split this vertical line. Move down and split this line. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Click this line, change your figure to 6 feet. Press enter and select this line. Change the figure to 10 feet. Press enter. Click on this grid and drag this wall backward to the other wall. Click out to deselect the wall. Now click the split element tool. Click on this line and this line. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Select this wall and move it down. Select this wall and change the value to 16 feet. Go to the quick access toolbar and select the dimension command. Click the down arrow and select individual reference. Select the face of this wall and the face of this wall. Click to place the dimension. Click the modify button. Select this wall and change the figure to 19 feet. Press enter. Select the dimension command, dimension, this face of this world to the face of this world, click to place the dimension. Make sure that this dimension says 26 feet 6 inches. If not, change, select the wall and change the value. Go to the modify panel and select the trim extend to corner. Select this wall and this wall, this wall and this wall, this wall and this wall. Press escape to get out of the command. Click the trim extend single element. Select the edge of this wall and extend this wall. Press escape. Right click this wall. Grid similar. Start a wall from this point. Move the mouse cursor and click on this point. Move the mouse cursor. When the snap alignment aligns to the center of this wall, click. Move the mouse cursor halfway through and click. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Select this wall and change this dimension to 8 feet. Press enter. Go to the quick access tool and select the align dimension. Align from the face of this wall to the face of this wall. Click to place the dimension. Now select this wall, change the value to 18 feet, press enter. Select this short wall and drag it close to this wall. Right click the reference plane and select grid similar. Zoom in. In the draw panel, click the pick line button and change the offset to 2 feet. Pick this bottom line to offset the reference plane down. Click on this grid box circle and extend the line to the left. Click the modify button on the selection panel. Now, go to the modify panel and select the trim extend multiple element. Select the reference plane. Click on this line and this line. Click the modify button to get out of the command. Click the trim extend single element. Click on the edge of this face. Click this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Right click the wall. Select grid similar. Draw a wall from this wall to this wall. Press escape. Select this wall. Change its value to 4 feet. Click into the empty area. Now use a crossing window to select all the objects on the drawing. Go to the filter, check none and check reference plane. We have 20 reference planes selected. Click OK. Now click the delete on the keyboard. Because the central reference plane are pinned, Revit prevents them to be deleted. Click close to close. This is the advantage of using reference plane in your model. Now select the dimension, this dimension, and hit delete on the keyboard to delete them. Right click the wall and grid similar. Draw a wall from this corner, move down and click and end the wall to this corner. Draw a wall from this point to this point. Press escape to get out of the corner. Click on this wall and change the value to 3 feet. Click in an empty area. Select this wall, change the value to 6 feet, click into this area, select this wall, zoom in, click on this grid to change the temporal dimension to the face of this wall, and change this value to 4 feet if yours is not 4 feet. Now right click the UCS, the reference plane, and select grid similar, select the pick line button. At the offset distance type 3 feet 6, offset this line up, click on this bubble to extend it to the right, go to the trim extend single element, select the reference plane that you just offset and trim off this wall. Press escape to get out of the command, select the reference plane and hit delete on your keyboard. Right click the reference plane, grid similar, start a reference plane from this point to this point, press escape. Press escape to get out of the command. Click the align dimension command. Make sure that the individual reference is selected. Zoom in and start. Place a witness line at the face of this wall and the face of this world and click on this reference plane. Move out the dimension and click. Click the EQ button to place this dimension in an equal part of to move this object in between the two walls. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Right click the reference plane and select create similar. Draw a reference plane from this point to this point. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Select, go to the quick access toolbar and select the align dimension command. Click this reference plane and this reference plane. This is dimension. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Select this reference plane. Change your figure to 3 feet 0.5 inches. Click grid similar, pick line button, and change the offset to 2 feet. Offset the line, the reference plane to the right. Press escape. Right click the wall, grid similar. Draw a wall from this endpoint to the endpoint of the reference plane. Press escape. Select the wall. Go to the modify panel and click the mirror command. Pick this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select the reference plane. Hold down the control key. Select this reference plane, and hit delete on your keyboard. Select the dimension, right click. Select all instants in the entire project and hit delete in your keyboard. Alright, we have created the walls. We have created the walls for our project. We're going to end this tutorial here. In the next tutorial, we'll start to fix doors in the project. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.